Typing commands fast in a terminal is really great, but you know what else is great? Not getting carpal tunnel syndrome in your 20s. The fact is, most of this work can get quite repetitive. What if I told you there was a simple solution that would put all of this behind you? Learn how to create shortcuts for any command and when not to. Welcome to Nextrix. I am Nick, and this is Bash Alias. How's it going, guys? Welcome back to the channel. This week we're looking at the alias command in Bash, and I cannot believe I didn't mention this sooner. This is the ultimate starter pack tool, the GigaChad of all tools for maximizing your command line efficiency. We've already covered tab completion and reverse search in my previous videos, now it's time to look into aliases, the what, how, when, and why. So let's get started. Aliases are custom shortcuts or abbreviations for longer or frequently used commands. They basically allow you to create your own commands or modify existing ones by assigning them a shorter and more memorable name. I did say bash aliases, and I am generally focusing on bash on my channel, but the alias command is available in other shells too, like Z shell, Corn shell, and Dash for Debian. Here are the top use cases for aliases. Long or complex commands that are very specific. Repetitive commands. Adding a safety net. Parameterized commands. Let's jump in and see this thing in action. The easiest and most straightforward way to show you how all of this works is by simply running the alias command. The syntax for creating a new alias is simple. Alias, the custom name we want, equals the command we want to run inside quotation marks. I like to wrap my aliases in single quotes in general and keep them simple and readable. If you run the alias command without any arguments, it's gonna display a list of all the aliases that are currently available to your session. I've emptied out my own aliases for this video because we're gonna make fresh ones, so all of these came packaged with PopOS.
Surprise, mother-
You can also pass the name of an alias to the command to have it listed and see exactly what it executes, but watch what happens if I close this terminal and open it again. Reverse search for my alias, and it's not there.
Surprise, mother-
On a serious note, the important thing here is that aliases are not persistent. To make them persistent, you will have to store their definitions in your shell's runtime config. Let's open up bashrc and look for alias. Here we can find the definitions of the default aliases that we saw earlier. And there's likely a comment here somewhere that says, you may want to put all your additions into a separate file like bash aliases, followed by a conditional that checks that the file exists and then sources it. The dot command here is specific to bash, but you may use the source command instead since it's the more portable version of that and it can be used with various other shell environments. So if you already have that section in your bashrc, you're all set. If not, you can simply just add it at the bottom of the file. I left it in the description if you want to just copy and paste it. We are now ready to add our own shortcuts to the bash aliases file, and they'll get registered on every new session. If you're not entirely used to or familiar with this mechanics, you may find it a bit odd that you edit your aliases file and they don't work right away. But that's normal since you are in the same session, which had in fact started before you made your changes and therefore had only registered at the beginning. What you can do is to manually source bashrc again or simply just start a new session. Alright, let's look at some examples. I'm gonna fire up Vim and start with a bunch of dot aliases since I mentioned it before. I'm using Tilex as my terminal emulator and I can split the view to spawn a new shell at the bottom. Let me go all the way into var log apt and test our aliases. That's dot dot and dot dot dot. Bang C to bring up the last command starting with C to go back to the apt directory. And I can test the four dots alias. Let's do another one since we're here. I don't know if you know about the cd dash, nifty little expansion to the previous directory that you were in. You're going to make a dash alias for it. The tricky part is that double dash here. We need to use it as a separator for the alias command to indicate the end of options, so that subsequent arguments that may start with a dash are not interpreted as options. Another one that is basic but useful for CD is to also list the contents of the target. I call it CDL and it runs ls right after CD. I mentioned interactive mode for RM, so let's try that as well. Make a file and run rm on it.
Remove regular empty file.
Yes, please. How about updating the system packages? That's a long one. We don't want to type it. Not every time. Alias UU for update and upgrade. -y to say yes to stuff and skip confirmation. Here's another one for ping. We're gonna call it Pong and have it send no more than 4 packages to the main Cloudflare public DNS resolver. And if you ever need to know your external IP, you can do a basic curl request to ifconf.me. I'll call this EIP for external IP, and that is totally my real external IP address. Now I want to show you an example that is deceivably simple at first glance. I want to make an alias called mkcd that will allow me to create a directory and then change to it right after.
Surprise, motherf***!
Last one, I promise. What we have here is a situation that requires the use of a function. Bash functions can easily handle arguments as we have in such cases. While it is common and arguably fine to have functions in your RC files and use them instead of aliases, I do prefer to write short inline functions and wrap them inside of aliases. I do this because of consistency reasons and the KISS principle. I believe it to be a good practice to write minimal complexity aliases and move any complex logic inside of dedicated bash scripts that get to live happily in my user binary directory. A few thumb rules for having a good time with aliases. There is such a thing as too many aliases. Try to aim for a good balance between usability and ease of use, if that makes any sense. Not everything needs to be an alias. Some things are inherently simple enough, others just make more sense as a standalone script. Don't take candy from strangers. It's great that people share their aliases, but if you don't understand something, it's always better to ask. Last but not least, try to write aliases that are personal to you and give them names that you can remember and feel comfortable with. I hope you liked the video. Please don't forget to give it a nice thumbs up if you did, and if you want to show your support for this new channel, you can subscribe or tell others about it too. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next one.